All right, let's recall long division of numbers and use that to our advantage to do long division of polynomials. All right, so let's take a look. We have 24 times 2 is 48. Do the subtraction, we get 19. Bring the 4 down. Then 24 times 8 will give me 192, and that will give me remainder of 2. So 674 divided by 24 is 28 whole plus 2 remainder. Now remember, we said that we can also keep going making a decimal. So I can put a 0 here and a point there. So I can bring the 0 down. 24 times nothing is going to give you 20, so it'll be 0. Then we can pull another 0 down here. All right, then what? 0, so 200. So that would be what? Times 8 again, which is 192 we saw before. Subtract, get an 8. So another 0 down here, which will give you what? So 24 times 3, which will give you 72. And look, 8, so looks like it repeats. So another way to write this would be what? Since the 8 is repeating, 28.083 repeating with the bar just on its head, just on the head of the 3. So that's the decimal number division if you wanted to keep going and get a repeating decimal. But otherwise, you can leave the answer here in some cases. 28 is your whole number quotient, and 2 would be your remainder. So let's see what we can do with polynomials then. In polynomials, they're going to work the same way. So we're going to have 2x plus 4 times what gets closest to this polynomial? All right, well, we can't really see how this is going to happen. You don't look at the whole number at once. You looked at the highest term first, which was the 6 in this case. So I look at the highest term here, which is the 6x squared. 2x times what gives me 6x squared? That's my 3x here. 2 times 3 is 6. X times x is x squared. Except now I have to make sure that I do 3x times 2x is 6x squared. 3x times 4 is my 12x. That's how you write this polynomial. Just like here, we wrote 2 times 24 is 48. So 3x times this whole polynomial is the answer here. 3x times 2x is 6x squared. 3x times 4 is 12x. Now you have to do a subtraction. So let's do this subtraction. 6x minus 12x is going to give you negative 6x. Just remember to have this minus sign all the way across. 6x squared minus 6x squared, that will be gone. The plus 4 is going to come down now, just like you had to bring this 4 down. So now what? 2x times what gives you negative 6x? Can you think of it? 2 times 3 is 6, so I would need a negative 3. And now multiply again. So negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. Negative 3 times 4 is going to be negative 12. So then you have to remember to do the subtraction. Negative 6x minus minus 6x will make it plus 6x. So those will add up to 0. 4 minus minus 12 will make it 16. Now, 2x times nothing is going to give you 16, because no matter what number you put, you're going to get something x. So that means you're done. So your quotient is 3x minus 3, and your remainder is 16 over the divisor, which is 2x plus 4. All right? So look at the similarity between those two. You look exactly the same way. You take this number times what gets closest here, do subtraction, and you keep going. Same thing here. You look at this polynomial, look at what comes closest to 6x squared, pick that, keep going until you get a remainder. In decimal numbers, one thing you can do is you can just keep going until you get a repeating pattern. All right, try this then on your own. So what are we going to do? It doesn't really matter how long these polynomials are. What's most important to remember here is just make sure you have a placeholder for every degree term. So this is second degree, first degree, zero degree. fourth degree, there is no cube term, so we're going to put a 0 x cubed as a placeholder for the x cubed term. And then write the rest because we have all those other terms. Now, 2x squared times what is 4x to the fourth? So 2 times 2 is 4. X squared times x squared will give me x to the fourth. So let's do that. But now what? You're going to take 2x squared times 2x squared is going to be 4x to the fourth. 2x squared times negative x is going to give you negative 2x. 2x squared times negative 2 is going to give you negative 4x squared. Now, once you have all these terms written, what do you have to do? You have to do a subtraction. So let's see. Negative x squared minus minus will make it plus 4x squared, giving you a 3x squared. 0x cubed minus minus will make it a plus 2x cubed. 4x to the 4 minus 4x to the 4 will cancel each other out. So now you're going to pull out x and pull down the negative 2. Now, 2x squared times what is going to give you 2x cubed? So 2 is already there, so we just need an x, so plus x. So again, multiply them. So x times 2x squared is my 2x cubed. X times negative 1x is going to give me negative x squared. X times negative 2 is going to give me negative 2x. And then finish off the subtraction. So 2x cubed minus 2x cubed is gone. 3x squared minus minus x squared will give me 4x squared. X minus minus 2x will give me plus 3x. Bring down the minus 2. So 2x squared times what will give you 4x squared. So that will be a plus 2. And then multiply it out again. 2 times 2x squared is 4x squared. 2 times negative x is negative 2x. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. And do the subtraction. So 4x squared minus 4x squared gone. 3x minus minus 2x will make it 5x. Negative 2 minus minus 4 will give me plus 2. 2x squared times nothing will give you 5x because you'll get x squared or higher power. So we're done then. This is your quotient and this is your remainder. Quotient and remainder. All right, this next question, I've done it all for you. We're just going to walk through it to make sure you understand. So x times 6x to the 4 is going to give me 6x to the 5th. 6x to the 4th times 2 is going to give me 12x to the 4th. So that number times all of that is this polynomial. Once you have that, remember, you're going to subtract now. Subtraction means if you don't put parentheses there, make sure you make the subtraction go all the way through. So that will become a minus, and that will become a minus. So that minus that will give you 0. 0x to the 4th minus 12x to the 4th will give you negative 12x to the 4th. Now, x times negative 12x cubed is going to give you negative 12x to the 4th. Negative 12x cubed times 2 is going to give you negative 24x cubed. Again, that minus sign goes all the way through, so that'll make it plus. Those two will give you 0. Negative 5x cubed plus 24x cubed will give you 19x cubed. Now, x times 19x squared will give you 19x cubed. 19x squared times 2 is 38x squared. Again, that minus sign will make these two become minus. So those two will give you 0. Positive 8x squared minus 38x squared will give you negative 30x squared. Negative 30x times x is negative 30x squared. Negative 30x times 2 is negative 60x. So again, that minus sign and that will make it plus. That will make it plus. Those two will give you 0. 10x plus 60x will give you 70x. The negative 12 can be pulled down. And now plus 70 times x will give you 70x plus 70 times 2 will give you 140. Again, that minus sign distributes across. So here and here, those two will give you negative 152. And now nothing times x will give you a number because you always get something x. So this is your quotient and this is your remainder. And so that's the final answer. Just remember to switch the signs when you are doing the subtraction so you don't make any mistakes. Try those on your own.